A very good morning, all my beloved students. See you once again. So, okay, how are you doing so far, everyone? Teacher, I hope you all okay are doing fine all together. And did you review your lesson as well? Because today you are going to have the test too, right? But okay, today actually in the first session, teacher also okay have some okay revision for all of you so that you can review some words and vocabularies. I think maybe you have okay review those okay words some of those words already. But now teacher would like to okay review a little bit regarding to what we learned so far okay in the okay previous weeks or in okay a few weeks okay already. So we learn okay a lot regarding to hangout lesson, okay, listening lesson, as well as the grammar lesson, right? So your test 2 is cover everything that we learned, okay? So actually for hangout, you can look at okay the vocabulary in your own textbook, okay, hangout textbook. So the teacher just wrote down some, so like the word record, the word okay silk road, which is in our reading, okay, you know silk road already, right? So in exam it may appear as well. All of these words will appear in your okay test 2 exam, so try to review it, okay? Like the word souvenir, the word compact disc, okay, it also have in our okay reading as well, that teacher Harry wrote down the definition. So try to review the definition of those words once again. And the word advice, profitable, okay, also in the okay reading as well with the Silk Road, okay, the develop photo, okay, the word play cassette tapes, okay, records video, okay, collect stamps, deliver newspaper, keep an address book, okay, use payphone, watch silent film, okay. You can actually look at more, okay, word that okay you already learned on page 35, like here, crawl, fall down, take naps, okay, how baby sister, okay, name's toy, catch butterfly, cry a lot, or fix your sibling. So you are going to mix those words, okay, during your test too. So try to remember, okay? And yes, that's it, okay, that teacher would like to show off you. And for the listening part, okay, so the listening part, you will wonder what are we going to do, right? So listening part is actually okay appears okay like before. You need to choose the okay best answer, or you need to circle the correct answer, okay? You can refer to your listening express listening practice, okay, here on page 25 we appear somewhere here, okay? So teacher just want you to look at once again, okay, regarding to unit 3, the old days, okay, talk about okay something that exists in the past. They talk about the equipment, like the okay the grandpa and grandma used to play, okay? So look at more on real time listening on page 23 and page 24 or page 25. And teacher would recommend all of you to look at those okay listening practice once again in your own textbook. Maybe you have already completed, so some of it may appear in your exam as well. So try to look at unit 3, okay? Mostly come from this unit in this test too, okay? For the listening part, you understand? And what you are going to do is, like teacher mentioned, you just need to complete. Sometimes they ask you to complete the okay words in the blanks, okay? And sometimes they need okay they ask you to circle the best answer or the correct answer, okay? So teacher hope you already understand. So once again, look at more on unit 3, okay, for the listening express, okay? You will encounter it tomorrow, okay? And actually for the grammar part, teacher also wanted to review for all of you. Look at here all together grammar. So what okay will appear in your exam, okay? You can look at present simple with the verb be that we learned. We have positive form, negative form, and question form, and simple past with the verb be as well. So now look at with the simple present with the verb be first. So actually you had already known a lot, and we also practice Okay, many exercises. So teacher, hope you all understand already. So actually for the okay present simple with the verb be, you need to know that subject I, okay, we use with to be am, and he, she, we use with to be is, and you, be there, we use with to be are. It is the main point. So you can put, okay, for example, in the present simple, sorry, in the present simple with the verb be in the positive form, or we call affirmative statement, we have subject, okay, so I, you, we, they. So here teacher just put subject she, and then have verb to be. So verb to be depend on the subject that you use. So for example, she used to be is, so we put is here. So she is my friend. Very easy. And okay, in the negative form we just add not, right? So she is not my friend. You see, it's very easy. You just add not, and it become okay. She it's become the negative form already. And for the question form, you just okay put the to be. Okay, you just put to be in front of the subject. Okay, before in the positive form we use to be okay after the subject, but in the question form we use to be in front of the subject. You understand? And then we have subject and then we have object as always. And for the simple past, okay, simple past is also okay very easy. So it's similar to the present simple with the verb be. So now moving on to simple past. And okay, for the simple past with the verb be, we have was and were. I, he, she, it, we use with was, and you, we, them, use with were, right? So you need to remember that. For example, the teacher put my mother was sick. So my mother, it represents subject she, right? So we use with was, because he, she, it, we use with was. Okay, while here we have the verb be, MSI. Okay, now we forget about this. So here we have was were instead. So my mother, which is she, he, she, we use with was, and you, we, them, use with okay were. Okay, he, she, it, and I use with was, and you, we, they, we use with were. So if, for example, my mother was sick, okay, like the teacher mentioned, so my mother is, okay, she represents subject she. Okay, represents subject she, so we use with was. And for the negative form, we just add not, like here in the simple present with the verb be, we just add not too, right? And yeah, so my brother's, brother with s, okay, it represents subject they, that's why I use with were, okay, not was. But if I put only my brother without s, so we use with was, and then it's plus not. So here is the short form, actually you can write down were, not, or weren't, okay? And then we have object, you understand? And for the okay question form, you just put to be first, like in the present simple as well. So you just put to be, for example, were you angry with me? So you use with, okay, the verb be were in the past simple, right? So were you angry with me? You understand? So you just put the okay verb be in the past simple first, and then you plus subject and you have object as always, all right? And question mark. And moving on to another lesson, we also learn about the present simple, but not with the verb be, we just with the general verbs, right? And you still remember, we have subject plus verb, okay, in the past form will be infinitive, plus object, alright? So she, which is subject, and works, why we, okay, do you still remember why we add s here? Very good, because okay, he, she, well, it's the third person singular. So when we use with the verb, you need to add s, okay, is, or okay, es, right? It depends on the verb. Okay, so you can look at the rules once again. Okay, present simple. Here, teacher will recommend all of you to look at these rules altogether, because in the exam, they may ask you to change it from the third person singular verb to the simple present. Okay, sorry, they may ask you to change okay, from the simple present, okay, the verb of simple present, and then you change it to third person singular or plural one. So you need to add s, es, so you need to remember the rule. For example, most verb it end with s, like works, w-o-r-k, so it does not include in the s-h-c-h-z or consonant plus y, so you just add s, right? But for some verb that end with s-c-h-s-h-z or x, in, when we use in the simple present in the positive form, you need to add es. And for the consonant plus y, like the word carry, so carry, c-a-o-o-y, so all y, consonant plus y, you need to change y to i-e-s. You understand? So you need to remember those rules, because they will ask you to change it from the simple present to the, okay, third person singular. Okay, so you understand? And okay, for if we look at the negative form of the simple present, you already know we have subject and we have auxiliary verb. We call, okay, that we have two auxiliary verbs, which are do and does in simple present. So we have do or does. So here, my sister do not. Why I choose do? Why I don't put does here? Because sister with s, so it represents subject they. So I, you, we, they, we use with auxiliary verb do. While he, she, it, we use with auxiliary verb does. You understand? And we only use it in the negative form and the question form. Do you still remember? While in the positive form, no. Okay? And you need to remember one more thing is that when we use with auxiliary verb, the verb here. So before, when we use here, okay, we add s or something like that, right? But in the simple present with the in the negative form or question form, because there is, okay, because there are the auxiliary verbs, okay, in the sentence of negative and question. So the verb here, you don't need to change it, okay, because we use auxiliary verb in a sentence. You still remember? So my sister do not work. So work here and then on Friday, okay? I forgot to put full stop. And for the question form, we have do or does plus subject, and then we have verb 1 as well, and then we plus object, right? So you don't need to change it, okay? Do your friend go? You see, you don't need to change it to goes or whatever, okay? But if you use in the positive form, like she goes, right? We add es because it ends with letter o. But in the negative, in the negative and question form, when we use with do or does, the verb here, even though it, okay, we use with, okay, he, she, it, the verb no need to change because we have the auxiliary verb do or does in the sentence. You need to remember that, okay, because it will, in, okay, it will appear in your exam as well. And the teacher would like all of you to look more on the present continuous, okay, that we learned so far last week. So it will appear as well. So they will ask you to order it in the correct, okay, order. For example, they can ask you, they put the verb is and then the word she and working and for something like that. So you need to order. So you still remember, right? For the present simple, sorry, for the present continuous, I have subject plus am is are and then we plus verb ing. Okay? And in the question, in the past, in the negative form, we have subject plus am is are and then we plus not and then plus verb ing and object, right? And for the questions one, you have to be, and you have subject and am is are. Sorry, to be, you have subject and verb ing and object and question mark. Right? So teacher would like all of you to look more. Okay, so actually, present continuous, you can look more on page 30 and 31. You see here, they also give all of you the okay form, right? And the example, you can look more. So for example, in affirmative, we have subject plus, okay, verb to be and the plus verb ing. Okay, and in the negative, we just put not after to be. And for the okay question form, you just put the verb be in front of the subject and you have subject and verb ing in object. It's similar to the simple present and simple past or simple present that we learned before as well regarding to the form. You just in the present continuous, we use with the verb ing. Okay, and teacher would like all of you to look at the rule. Maybe it will appear as well. Mm-hmm. So that's it for our review of today class. Teacher, hope you all review more, okay? Because your teacher also dropped the video of you, okay? Today, okay, maybe in the evening around 7 p.m., right? So you can look and review more tonight. And tomorrow, teacher, hope you all, okay, good luck in your test two all together and fighting, right? And see you once again, okay, on Wednesday. Goodbye!